68 deers, 14 housemates, only 5 remain.
This is the final Big Brother.
For me to come this far, I'm really proud of myself.
I'm so happy and so excited for tonight, it's ridiculous.
Oh my gosh, imagine if I were to win, that would be amazing. That would be so great, it would be like the best thing ever.
I would really, really like to get my fairy tale ending.
Who wins Big Brother? You decide! The live final of Big Brother. Please welcome your host, Emma Willis.
After 68 days of slanging matches, conspiracy theories and half-hearted love triangles, 5 housemates have made it all the way to the final. They have survived secrets, lies and DCs, which is deep conversations in case you didn't know. More than we could handle, to be honest. Tonight, we were going to be crowning your champion and handing over £100,000 of for second place. Only one person can walk out of those doors and into the exclusive Big Brother Winners Club. Who leaves victorious and who takes the long walk home with the leftover lentils is entirely down to you at home. From a landline, call 090 20 50 58 and add the number of the housemate that you want to win. From a mobile, call 650 58 and add the number of the housemate you want to win. For Charlie to win, add 02. For Dexter to win, add 05. For Gina to win, add 06. For Jack and Joe to win, add 08. For Sam to win, add 12. Mobile and BT landline votes cost 35p. Other landlines may vary. Voting closes later in the show. Votes cast after the lines close won't count. Please do not try to vote if you're watching Channel 5 Plus One or on demand. And for full terms, go to channel5.com/BBVote. Okay, lines will be freezing in a few minutes. But before we go down to Eviction Town, how about we welcome back a few familiar faces? I know you love this bit. It is your housemates. Sally can't be here this evening because she's not very well, so get well soon, Sally. What a bunch match, though. All killer, absolutely no filler. And to be a fly on the wall in that green room, it would be unbelievable. Right, it's almost time to get down to business. But before we do, here's the final bit of reality from the house. And Sam, it's now or never.
Dear 67, 10 or 1 a.m. It's the final full day in the Big Brother house.
There is a house built out of stone. Wooden floors, walls, and windowsills.
After weeks of indecision, Charlie has come to a conclusion.
If I'm completely honest, it's a bit strange that every single person's commented, and even Dan coming back up and the subject coming up, that you're full of shit and that you're playing some amazing game, and even your tweets were, what a great game player and all this stuff. And I know you... It's just, it makes it... it's just very strange. I don't believe the things you say add up categorically now, like I've made my mind up. I apologise if I'm wrong. I do think I do think we're close. I do think we get on really well. I do think there's some sort of connection there in terms of we have a real laugh together, and I do think you care about me a bit, but I do not believe any of the other stuff you say.
At 8:45 p.m.
I can't believe we made it to the final there. 2 months.
Sam has a last-minute revelation for Gina.
Over the last month, I have grown to appreciate you.
Okay.
Gina, I know you got a boyfriend, nah. I don't want to come between you. Like, I think you're a wonderful girl, nah. I feel we do connect more than people I connect with anyway. No, but you got a boyfriend, and I respect that. I would never come on to you. No, I wouldn't even let you know that I like you.
You just did.
Oh, fuck it. I'm going to wish I got for you. Oh,
you know what?
Shit.
You know what? At least you're honest.
I'm honest.
Is there anything else you want to say to me? Because it's all going to come to an end tomorrow, and we might not see each other again.
Your boyfriend really lucky. Baby.
He's still drunk.
Yeah. Better know what I'm saying. Doesn't really matter. Whatever I say, it doesn't matter, because this time tomorrow night, it'll be different. So, if I find someone, I come across someone and they have the same personality as you, I know we're going to get along. Yeah?
Aww, yeah. That's cute.
That's something. Anyway, are we cool?
Yeah, of course.
Done. Just go. Is there anything you want to say? Other than bon voyage.
Bon voyage.
As it's their final night, Big Brother is treating housemates to a slideshow.
Jack, you look really
slim. You look gorgeous.
You look really slim.
You look really thin.
Oh my
you
god,
look smaller.
That's at the top. That's at the top of the stairs.
Oh my god.
This is a sad moment because I've achieved my dream, but it's coming to an end.
Yay! Yay!
Cheeky little
cheeky man. Oh my god.
What happened to that bath?
Oh my god, that was my birthday.
I think that we've learned that we can both be like individual people, individual personalities sort of thing. And we don't always have to
And we don't always have to be Jack and Joe, we can be
Jack and Joe.
Oh!
That's fantastic. I feel like it's too good to be true. I feel like oh, I was so happy. Yeah, like it's all I've ever wanted to really, so it's just amazing. I'm so happy.
Dexter as well.
If anybody ever says to me, like, do you think I should do Big Brother? I'd just be like, yes, 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 yes. Just do it, do it, do it, do it, do it. Because everyone will take something from this, and what you take from it will sort of change the way that you deal with the rest of your life.
Oh,
hey!
Oh wow.
That was last night.
That was last night, wasn't it?
No, Sophie.
Oh, Sophie! My lovely Sophie!
It takes a strong person to live in the Big Brother household, and I've said that numerous amount of times, even for people that I haven't genuinely liked, and hats off to everyone that's been in the Big Brother house, because it's so hard and so tough.
That's like our life instills. That's like a family album.
Oh my god.
Congratulations, everyone.
Night to Jenny. Woo! Voting since Friday, and the results are now in. It's time to talk to the house. Big Brother House, this is Emma. Spoken, your fate is sealed. For the last 4 days, the British public have been voting for their winner. I can now reveal the housemate with the fewest votes, and in fifth place is Charlie.
Charlie. See you soon. See you on the side.
Charlie, you have lost your place in the Big Brother house. Please say your goodbyes.
I love you. Oh, I love you. See you in a bit. Good luck, everyone.
You'll rock it, Charlie.
Charlie, you have come fifth. Please leave the Big Brother house.
Right. Go, Charlie, rock it.
We'll see you in a minute.
Charlie, please leave the Big Brother house immediately.
opened for you to vote for your winner. From a landline, call 090 20 50 58 and add the number of the housemate that you want to win. From a mobile, call 650 58 and add the number of the housemate you want to win. For Dexter to win, add 05. For Gina to win, add 06. For Jack and Joe to win, add 08. For Sam to win, add 12. Mobile and BT landline votes cost 35p. Other landlines may vary. Voting closes later in the show. Please do not try to vote if you're watching Channel 5 Plus 1 or on demand. And for full terms, go to channel5.com/BBvote. So, Charlie Travers is out of the house. I'm going to be getting the 411 on Life in the House after the break. We'll see you very soon. Evening, you have decided that Charlie was not worthy of the Big Brother crown, which means Dexter, Gina, Jack and Joe, and Sam are still in with a chance of taking the title. Who wins is entirely down to you. There is no time for messing about. The vote lines will freeze again in 1 minute's time, so get cracking. Right now, though, we've got a brand new finalist to catch up with. Should we go meet Charlie? Did you ever think you'd make it into the final, going into that house 10 weeks ago?
Absolutely not a chance. I really thought that I'd make it 3 weeks maximum, and my absolute best, my dad said to me, Charles, you're not going to go further than the week six. Thanks a lot, Dad.
So you must be absolutely chuffed. I know you didn't win, but you still came fit, and you're in the final.
Oh, I'm so happy. I literally never thought I'd be here. I'm so thankful. You don't understand. I'm so delighted.
OK, well, listen, because there's so many of you coming out tonight, yeah. We don't have a lot of time, so let's not beat around the bush. Let's talk about your admirers.
Yes.
You had a couple of them in that house. Dexter,
yeah.
You were the centre of his attention, and Callum. What was it like being in a love triangle?
It was, honestly, I don't even know how it ended up being a love triangle. I really don't know how
it
got there.
It was kind of a love triangle that wasn't.
Yeah, it was never really a love triangle. I don't think that Dexter's feelings are genuine. I never have felt, and then I started getting sucked into it, and I think actually they're not real at all. A lot of his actions don't match his words. And Callum, I think his feelings were genuine. He's a nice guy, but they
weren't
for me.
We did hear Dexter say last night that you were his soulmate and that he loved you.
He did say he loved me.
Do you buy any of it?
Absolutely, no, not at all.
Really?
On reflection, I got very lost in the house, and I think I had no idea what I was doing half the time, and I got lost in a big whirlwind, but I came to realisations yesterday morning that it was all a load of potential rubbish.
But do you think he
rubbish.
Would carry it on for this long if he really didn't like you?
Yes.
Oh.
I think he would. He's an incredibly intelligent person. I really have, you know, I admire him a lot. He's very, very good at reading people, and observational skills are fantastic. But I'm not sure his real feelings. He's a great game player. He's an ex-gambler, so I don't know. I can't read his face. He's got a good poker face.
He does have a good poker face. I'm still quite baffled by him as well. But
yeah.
I love
he's
that.
He's very intriguing,
him,
though, that's for sure.
He's very
really
intriguing. So is there any future?
Not in that way. I mean, we have a lot of fun together. Like, my week last week wouldn't have been as fun without him. Like, we had a great laugh. So, as a friendship, definitely. Anything more than that, no.
Okay. Now, you were a much-loved housemate inside and outside of the house, but there was one thing that used to irk people a little bit, and that was your big feet that you used to put into
big
things
old boots
and say
here.
Things without thinking. Is this normal for you?
Yeah. Can you vouch for that? yeah, it is. I know some people have said that I'm not really that naive, but I really am split personality sometimes. I can be on the ball and I can be extremely naive, and that's just me. I'm a walking contradiction, and I always have been. So
do you think the house has helped you to realise stuff about yourself?
Yeah, it's been the best thing that's ever happened to me. I really, it's been amazing.
Very quickly, let's talk about Hazel. You had a great relationship, sometimes quite stormy. We saw a couple of rows. Why do you think things got rocky between you a couple of times?
I'm not really sure. I've obviously, as you know, that I've had a lot of trust issues, and I never really was sure what she. I get so distracted. Yeah, no, I love Hazel to pieces. We had a great bond. We were very, very close. And we just had a fallout, and that was it. You know, I still
well,
very much like her.
You can move on and be friends afterwards.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing her. I can't wait.
Who would you like to win?
Sam.
They're your best bits. Thank you, Charlie. It's Jackie and Charlie.
That was the most surreal experience I've ever had.
It's lovely to have it here. It's like having a piece of home with me.
Shut up, Charlie. Stop it. I'm having my say.
Stop it. We're having fun.
No, we're not.
Charlie's a beautiful girl.
That's lovely.
You get to have the go, Callum.
Charlie. That's bullshit.
I didn't expect to meet someone like you in here.
No. Do you fancy Charlie?
Yes.
And you?
No, I don't.
My second nomination is going to be Charlie.
She's nice to the boys 1 minute and talking behind the backs the next. Charlie manipulates the house.
She must be doing something that we don't know about.
So in my head, it was more of a conscious thing. And
okay,
then
I get it. You said all you needed to say there.
I'm just feeling so lost.
What do you feel like? You're not loved anymore? Oh, don't be silly. I love you.
It's just how Daddy felt.
That's pretty harsh, Charles.
Oh, my God.
I don't really think before I speak sometimes. I just speak.
Are you a bit of a rave, Dave? Dave? What's your name? Charlie!
Charlie's a lovely girl. She's a really, really lovely girl.
She is a lovely girl.
You're just hitting with an egg.
It's not often you get girls that are nice, caring, funny, stylish. She ticks quite a lot of boxes.
Hello.
Fuck me.
Brilliant experience. I'll never forget being in here. It's the best thing I've ever done in my whole life.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much. Go and see your friends and family down there. Okay, so Charlie's gone. She'll be reunited with Jackie Travis sooner than you know it. Okay, so one housemate down. Are you thirsty for more? I bet you are. It's time to talk to the housemates again. Big Brother House, this is Emma. Dexter. Gina. Jack and Joe. The viewers have spoken. Your fate is sealed. For the last 4 days, the British public have been voting for their winner. I can now reveal the housemate with the fewest votes. And in fourth place is... and Joe.
Oh, yes, praise the public. Good luck.
I love you so much.
Jack and Joe, you have lost your place in the Big Brother house. Please say your goodbyes.
That'll be fine. Oh, here we go, here we go.
Here we go.
Jack and Joe, you are in fourth place.
Thank you very much.
Please leave the Big Brother house.
Come on, people.
Oh, I'm not forgetting the pose.
becoming Big Brother champion. Who takes it is entirely up to you. For Dexter to win from a landline, call 090 2050 5805. Or from a mobile, 650 5805. For Gina to win from a landline, call 090 2050 5806. Or from a mobile, 650 5806. For Sam to win from a landline, call 090 2050 5812. Or from a mobile, 650 5812. Landline votes cost 35p. Other landlines may vary. Voting closes later in the show. Votes cast after the lines close won't count. Please do not try to vote if you're watching Channel 5 Plus 1 or on demand. And for full terms, go to channel5.com/BBVote.
Hello.
Hi. Okay, in a few minutes, I'm going to be catching up with Jack and Joe, and we'll be edging one step closer to crowning your winner. Hello and welcome back to Big Brother the Live Final. Okay, there are now only three housemates left, but there can only be one winner. Whose Big Brother dream do you want to come true? Voting will freeze again in 1 minute, so no dilly-dallying, please. Right, we've got a new finalist. Are you ready for a chinwag with Jack and Joe? Beginning, when you walked into that house, did you ever think you'd be sat here on finale night?
No, not a chance.
Really?
I thought it was going to be out week three, and he thought we might get to our birthday.
My sister said to me, I won't see you to final, and I laughed her off. I went, oh, of course you will, and then obviously she hasn't. I can't wait to hug them.
I've been hanging out with your sister.
Have you?
Yeah.
Well, that one just down there.
That one just there.
No, you're the one.
Oh, I've got three.
You're another one.
I've got three.
Katie.
Yeah, that's the one that's going to make it.
Anyway, let's talk about you. Ever since you first got put up for eviction, you were convinced that you were going to go. You said, that's it. Every week now, we're going to be up until we leave. Why did you think that?
I don't know. We just sort of knew. It was really obvious that, like, because... I don't know, maybe easy target, no, because that's not right. But I know, but maybe we just knew.
You'll be up, but it didn't really bother us out after a while, it became the new normal.
Yeah,
it was quite exciting on Friday nights hearing your voice. And, oh, I've got a microphone.
I think maybe you're the special one, or maybe your mic's just not working.
I'll speak through this.
Now, you loved having a laugh in the house, and you said when while you're in there, you're here to have fun.
Yeah.
But sometimes we did see you snap. Was it difficult holding your temper?
Yeah, especially with Dexter. Oh, my God, that boy is aggravating to hell. Oh, I can't express how annoying it is to know that he's playing a game. He's played a game since day one. And then he's mugging Charlie off, and then he's mugging everyone off, and it's just like, oh, my God. And it's aggravating.
Some would say, though, it is a game.
Oh, no, appreciate.
Oh, no, it's a game, but at the end of the day, he's playing it like a mug, so he's not going to do well out of it. Let's be honest.
Like a mug. Was there anybody else in there? Now that I've got you in the mood, is there anybody else in there that wound you up?
I had one or two arguments with Dan, but I think that's because we were very similar. Sorry, Dan.
Wolfie was quite arrogant sometimes.
Oh, I'm seeing Dan now.
I can see Dan's face. Wolfie was quite arrogant sometimes, and that is a pet hate of mine. I can't stand that.
But no, other than that, we loved everyone. We had a screaming BB13. It was just amazing. So.
You were accused sometimes of not liking DCs, which are deep conversations, in case you're not
following. We didn't like DCs, ACs, PCs, none of them.
Why didn't you like DCs?
Oh, my God, they're so boring.
What a waste of a day. You're just sitting there going, oh, I'm so fed up with this, I'm so fed up with that. Get a grip. You're in the Big Brother house. Smile.
When you're sitting in that... it's like when you're sitting in that house and then all you hear is, oh, my life this, my life that. It's like, oh, my God, bore
I can't
off.
Believe
bore
how, me. I can't believe I'm so lucky to be here. We're all lucky to be here. Like, we know that. So yeah. let's not waste a day on it, be honest.
Did you ever have a DC?
No,
I think I might have had one with Callum and...
put it right there.
Just well one. Done. Oh, maybe actually, just one, but that was not.
I tried my hardest not to, if I'm honest.
Yeah, we
don't
know
bother
you
me too much.
We know you.
Give away from those.
I can't be bothered.
You didn't get on with Dexter, as we've already covered, but one person who you did get on phenomenally well with was Sophie.
Oh my God, I love Sophie.
I love Sophie and Hayley.
Were you shocked that she left on Friday?
Yes, she shouldn't have left.
She shouldn't have left. She was a
finalist. She should be sitting in there now instead of Dexter. She should be.
She should be the winner.
Why do you think you both stick so well?
What's her?
do you think you click so well?
From the moment when she walked down the stairs, I was just like, oh my God.
I heard her voice, and it sounds weird. It reminded me of home. And it was at Hazel's. I heard hers, and it just reminded me of home.
In Ireland home. So it was just like, oh.
I just was friends with both of them.
Well, you do have a very similar vocabulary. As you just said, he's mugging everyone off.
Yeah, in all fairness, we are quite similar sometimes.
Now, you were one housemate.
Indeed.
As we know. Were there ever any times when you would have liked to have been individual?
Oh, my God, last week. Maybe. Maybe a bit.
One word.
It was when he was so negative last week, and he was like, I miss home, and it was just like, oh, my God, stop it, like, you're boring me now. And then we're sitting in the diary room, and that chair's small. That was really
small. That chair's very small. None of you appreciate how small that chair is.
We're large lads. So, like, when we're sitting on this chair, and then, like, he's, like, doing one thing, and I'm thinking, you're doing it all wrong. And then
I had my nice chats with him on my own.
But I'm happy we did it together, because I could not have walked in and out together.
Do you think he was jeopardising possibly getting further?
If you say yes, I'm disappointed.
No, because, like, you can't help... you can't help how you feel. Like, everyone says it every year and you think, oh, my God, you're boring me, but it is so tough
It's the toughest 10 weeks of your life.
OK. Mm. But two words, very quickly. Shane from Westlife.
Shut up!
Drop me out! I could not believe that! We wasn't sure if it was real, because that was the mug off
week, wasn't
it? And we were all just like, is it really him? I got so excited.
It was him.
Who would you like to win?
Sam.
Oh, Sam.
Boys, you've been fantastic. Here are your best bits.
Oh, there you go.
It's Jack and Joe!
Oh, my God.
Hello, Jack. Hello, Jack.
This is all too much, all too much! I fucking love this show!
I knew you liked fat people.
I knew you was a fat people liker.
You can have shepherd's pie, lasagna, whatever you want, I'll make it for you.
We're gonna be friends! Can you eat toothpaste?
I do for full English.
My policy consists of meat sweats.
Do you ever get meat sweats?
Love the meat sweats.
Oh. Well, I'm only giving the public what they want.
What? I'm only fat kid.
You gotta say thank you to me and Jackie, because you haven't done that yet.
You normally say thank you at the end.
You're being absurd.
You normally say thank you at the end.
No, you say thank you when you sit down.
No, you're wrong.
This is a piss take. I look like a fucking prick.
Just thought I'd come say hello. I've just really missed you.
You need to, like, cut out the really deep conversations because they're tedious and boring, and then just bring back the fun.
Jack and Joe, they're legends. Especially in the swimming pool as well, they're hilarious.
Look to me! He's gone! Help me!
Twins, they're just twins. I love them.
Run, piggy, run!
I am your father.
My dad's going to be so proud of me!
You're here for the experience. I've had an amazing time. I've had fun.
And what's the one where...
Cliché?
Cringy.
Thank you very much. Thank you for meeting.
Thank you. No. Cheers is about to get cray cray. It's time to talk to the house. Big Brother House, this is Emma. Dexter. Gina. Sam. The viewers have spoken. Your fate is sealed. For the last 4 days, the British public have been voting for their winner. I can now reveal the housemate with the fewest votes, and in third place is... Gina, you have lost your place in the Big Brother house. Please say your goodbyes.
Okay. Oh.
Gina, you are in third place.
Anna.
Please leave the Big Brother house.
Oh, my God, how amazing. Oh, my God, this is so amazing.
Come on, Gina.
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 Oh.
Gina.
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 Gina. Gina.
Gina. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Gina.
Gina.
Gina. Gina.
Gina.
to this. Voting has reopened for the final time. It's down to you to choose your champion. It's between Dexter or Sam. Only one can be crowned the winner of Big Brother. For Dexter to win from a landline call 090 20 50 58 05, or from a mobile 650 5805. For Sam to win from a landline call 090 20 50 58 12, or from a mobile 650 5812. Mobile and BT landline votes cost 35p. Other landlines may vary. Voting closes later in the show. Please do not try to vote if you're watching Channel 5 Plus One or on demand. And for full terms, go to channel5.com/BBVote. Voting closes for good in 11 minutes, so you better get a little wriggle on. I'm going to be catching up with Gina straight after this break. We'll see you in a bit. Big Brother, the live final. Yes, indeed. So it's now a fight to the finish between Dexter and Sam. Lines close for the final time in 6 minutes. So if you still want to vote for your winner, then you need to do it now. Before all of that, though, congratulations to our third place. Gina's here. So, Gina, listen. On the way in, booed.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
On the way out, cheers. Yeah. How does that make you feel?
Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. And no words can describe how I feel right now.
Oh, God.
You seem quite nervous.
Yes.
Is it strange to kind of be back in the outside world and in reality?
Yeah, it feels like I'm going to go back in again. It feels weird, like another fake eviction. I don't know.
This isn't a twist, a secret, or a lie. This is genuinely the final of Big Brother.
Oh, it's weird.
Now, you went in with the title of most spoilt girl in Britain.
God. Oh,
and you've made it. You said yourself you thought you'd be out in the first week, and you've made it all the way through to the final. You've come in third place. How do you think, why do you think the public perception of you changed?
Because they've just seen me for who I really am, and I'm not this sport girl in Britain. I'm just me, I'm just humble, I'm caring, and, you know, I'm just still human, I'm just myself.
And was that your mentality throughout the whole process? Because in the beginning, we kind of see... Oh, it's okay, don't worry, it's just a cushion. In the beginning, we kind of saw you go, I'm just going to wash my own cup up. And by the end of it, you got your marigolds on quite often and you were having a good old clean.
Yeah. It's quite strange because I had a completely different mentality when I actually walked in, and I thought I'm just going to do things for just myself. And then I grew to like the people, you know, of the other housemates, and, you know, we started working as a team and it was just great.
Do you think you've changed as a person then? Not you personally, but maybe the way you kind of interact with people and how you are socially.
Absolutely. At first, like, a lot of people were saying to me, you know, you've really, really changed since the girl that walked through those doors on launch night. And I actually thought it was quite rude. I was like, you know, you didn't know me before I came in, so why are you saying this? But then I actually noticed myself, so...
So do you think now that you're back on the outside world, you are going to continue maybe some of the things that you started to do in the house that you maybe didn't do before you went into the house? Like, is your lovely boyfriend Ed going to have to start washing up all the time again? on that note, let's talk housemates. Let's start with Dexter.
Oh, yeah.
Game player or misunderstood young man?
I think he's misunderstood, and I think he's so adorable. He's such a sweetheart, and absolutely love him.
We saw you last night going, oh my goodness, when you heard him tell Charlie that he loved her.
Oh, so annoying.
What I'm going to ask you a final time. What are your thoughts on that?
I think it's just a fake, like, thing. I don't understand what it is, but I think he's actually grown feelings for her over the time. At first, I think it was quite fake, but then afterwards, I thought it was actually quite real. But on her half, it's just, yeah.
So do you think there's any future for them?
Oh, no, absolutely not. Definitely not. No. I'll be shocked.
Okay, you certainly held your own in that house. From, well, day one, really, there was arguments.
Oh,
and my goodness, you were a firecracker.
Oh, Lord.
Especially when it came to Hazel.
Oh, God.
Why did she get your back up so much?
Sorry?
Why did she get your back up so much?
I don't know. She's just a nasty person. I've never met such an individual like that in my entire life.
if maybe now that you're out of such a, the pressure cooker environment of the Big Brother house, yeah. maybe you could kiss and make up and be
no
friends.
Way, absolutely not. I have no reason to.
That's right.
Really? Okay. Was there anybody else in the house that really wound you up?
Obviously Jemima, but then I didn't dislike her in a bad way or anything like that.
I suppose
that.
You I didn't have a lot of time to get used to her either.
Yeah, that too. No one else really that I can think of right now. I grew to love everyone, actually.
You did say towards the beginning of your time in the house that you didn't really care about making friends.
Yeah.
Now that you've been in there for 10 weeks, did you make any true friends, do you think?
Yes. Sam and Dexter.
Who are still there right now.
I know, I'm so proud of them and I love them both.
Sam kind of admitted in a roundabout way he had a little crush on you. Yesterday.
Oh, yeah, everyone knew.
You looked quite awkward
yeah,
with that situation.
So oh, my gosh, so awkward. And I'm quite glad that you didn't tell me beforehand because it would have been so awkward, like, you know, yeah. living with him. So, yeah.
But at least he kept it to the end.
Yeah.
They are your two friends. Who do you think would win?
Sam!
Maybe Sam, but then I love them both, so I'll be happy either way.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Another one. It's gonna be hard sharing a toilet with the same people. It's gonna be hard sharing cutlery as the same person. What? I could catch something, you know.
She's lazy, she's spoiled, she's pretentious, she's not a team player.
Are you doing all the dishes?
No.
Big Brother, can I just ask you a quick question? What does it smell in here?
Gina's an angel, but she's a very naughty little angel.
Don't like people who can't wash their own cup, who can't pack their own suitcase.
That's the shit I don't like.
I just hate everyone. It's just, I just don't want to talk to any of them. I just don't want to.
You're disgusting.
Shut the fuck up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
You're a disgusting little girl. Oh, I'm so happy!
She's absolutely hilarious.
Gina!
Sting
again.
She's just got this amazing, adorable sort of quality.
Something hit my hair.
The diary room door is now open.
Love ya. Bye. And thank you, everyone.
Party is going to be hashtag awkward. So that's it, the lines are now closed. Dexter and Sam, one of them is going to be crowned your champion tonight. Do not move from your sofas. We're going to be back here in 1 hour with the results. Who is going to win? I don't know. Right now though, we've got a real treat for you. It's the first of a brand new series called Under the Dome. It's meant to be fantastic. We'll be back here at 11 with the final. We'll see you very soon. We'll be right back.